Now let's get into the nuts and bolts. I will take you through the changes to the performance requirements of the PCA. First thing I know you're going to ask, what is quantification? Quantification is the expression or measurement of something, and you will see what I mean as we work our way through them. A large amount of work has been undertaken in reviewing the performance requirements of the PCA to ensure that these high-level objectives of the code set out a measurable target to meet when undertaking a performance solution. Quantified performance requirements will make it simpler to know if the solution being used will meet these requirements, as well as it being easier for a regulator to confirm that the solution complies. The amended performance requirements are what we call a policy-neutral change. This means that whilst the clause was changed, the technical objective has not. This is still a work in progress, however, with a number of performance requirements still to be identified, but over the next few slides, I'll step you through the changes so far to the requirements of 2022. The first performance requirement relates to the flow rates of a cold water service. As you can see, the 2019 requirement didn't really give you much to work towards, and determining the appropriate flow rates for the correct functioning of fixtures is tricky. The 2022 requirement is a lot more specific, outlining a limit of 3 meters per second. The reference to 1% refers to how much time that the system would be expected to exceed this maximum velocity during the period of peak use, which is referred to as the annual peak hour. This one is another great example. It could be difficult to demonstrate that you have designed a service to efficiently use drinking water. However, it is easy to ensure that your showers, basins, and sinks use no more than 9 liters per minute, or that the toilets being used flush no more than 6 and 3 or 4.5 and 3 litres. You'll see that subclause B, however, at the bottom also allows for flexibility should a performance solution require. However, it still works in conjunction with the first part to provide a means of compliance measurement. This one is for pressure. The required pressures of a water service is also another area which has received some attention in 2022. This change has provided a limit of between 50 kPa and 500 kPa, which gives you a parameter and is much easier to demonstrate compliance. You will see that the second subclause, subclause B, will continue to provide the flexibility if you need to work outside of these pressures. This one is about heated water services. Heated water flow rates have received the same treatment as cold water services. This performance requirement has been broken down into reticulated systems and circulatory systems. Circulatory systems have been then separated between copper systems and other pipework materials, as they can cater for different velocities. This one is about excessive pressure for the temperature and pressure relief of water heaters. If you look at the 2019 requirement, you might be a bit stumped on what is considered excessive pressure, or what temperatures you need to limit the system to in order to prevent flash steam production. Now with the quantification, a specific temperature and pressure is listed. And again, there is a degree of flexibility if that performance solution being used needs to deviate beyond these limits. Legionella is a major ongoing issue in warm water, so another area which has been updated is the requirement for Legionella control. The performance requirement now sets a target Legionella count that a heated water system must be designed to achieve. This limit aligns with the advice provided by the health departments. With this firefighting water services provision, you can see that this requirement is set at the 95th percentile, not 1% as per the cold water service. This works the same way, but rather than exceeding no more than 1% of the time, or operating correctly 99% of the time, this requirement sets a 95% target. This provides an additional safety factor for firefighting water services to ensure that the service pressures and the flow rates for firefighting water services are correct. The safety factor is important, as having the right flow rates and pressures is critical in ensuring that the firefighting water service works when it is needed. And the last example is for sanitary plumbing ventilation. As you can see, the quantified performance requirement provides a limit of both positive and negative pressures within the system. This pressure limitation is to set to ensure the trap seals are not affected and continue to prevent the escape of sewer gases into the building. This requirement obviously does not apply to a vacuum drainage system, which operates in a negative pressure. This is the last quantification example I have for you, but watch this space for 2025 as we continue to work our way through the performance requirements of the PCA.